Geo Maps to visualize country, state, or city data in Data Studio? In this video, I'm going to show you how to create them so you can easily prove the value of your marketing efforts in different countries or regions. Okay, so we all know data is the key to unlocking marketing performance. That's nothing new. But part of the marketer's role is to communicate data. Often this is to prove the value of your marketing efforts to managers, C-suites, and boards. Because let's be honest, everyone wants to know what's happening to those marketing dollars. Am I right? Okay, let's dive in. The first thing you need to do is choose the right data. If you want to visualize a country, you'll need a country dimension and a metric you want to show at the country level. Let's say, for argument's sake, impressions by country, or GA sessions by country. Depending where you clean and organize your data will depend on what dimensions and metrics you send to Google Data Studio and how you send them there. I'm really fortunate that at Funnel, we use Funnel and my country data from each platform is already mapped together and ready to send over. You can see when I go into the country dimension that we've used some simple logic to essentially tell Funnel how to organize all the different country level data from each platform. Because believe it or not, country isn't represented the same way in each platform. Shocker. So, for all Google Ads data, country gets converted to lowercase, and the same for Bing and Google Analytics. But for Facebook, you can see we needed an extra step of logic because the country dimension in Facebook ads is actually only the country code. So for Sweden, it's SE, and for France, it's FR. Hence, we needed that extra step to turn country code into country name and then turn it into lowercase. It sounds like a lot of work, and in a Google Sheet, it is. It's just that at Funnel, we use Funnel, so it's super easy drop-down logic stuff. And then for LinkedIn, Campaign Manager, Capterra, and HubSpot, there are some other unique steps too. But basically what this gives us is a combined aggregated country dimension across all platforms with just a few clicks. Much easier than a big complicated Google Sheet with loads of complicated formulas. Okay, so now we need to connect our data to Google Data Studio. Since our data is in Funnel, we can either send it from Funnel to Data Studio from the Funnel interface, or we can choose Funnel as a data source in Data Studio and connect using the token ID. I think it's easier in the Funnel's interface, so I'll just go ahead and click Data Studio and choose Views right here. I'll then select what fields I want to send. So I'm obviously going to send the country dimension we just looked at, and to make it simple, I'll also send impressions, since we have those from all platforms, and GA sessions, since we also have sessions from all platforms. I'll also select geostate so I can show you a cool drill down at the end. The crucial step. Don't really know what that was. Anyway, now I connect to Data Studio. Once I'm at this point, I need to do the crucial step that enables me to utilize this fantastic GeoMaps feature in Data Studio. I need to change the country dimension from a string to a geo-country. I'll also change geo state to country subdivision 1, given that states are the largest breakdown in the US. More on that later. And now I'll create the report. As you can see, because I only sent these four fields, this is the only data I have to work with. But I could also just send all my data from the Funnel account so I can create comprehensive reports with multiple pages, etc., etc. I'm going to insert geochart, then select dimension as geocountry, the metric as sessions, and the zoom area as world. Now I can hover over and see which countries bring in what sessions. This is just the last 28 days, and as you can see and might expect, the US, UK, France, Germany, and Sweden are the darkest and the source of most of our sessions. If I look at the US for a second here, I can see this number for sessions. But where the US is concerned, states actually act very differently from a performance point of view. So I'm just going to create a slightly different chart looking on the state by state level. I go through the same process, but this time select the drill down and choose geostate as the drill down. Then I go to zoom area and choose US. The cool part about Geo Maps in Data Studio is they're very interactive. So if I click on View, I can hover over each of the states and see the total number of sessions per state for the last 28 days. So that is how you use cool Geo Maps in Google Data Studio. If you have any cool Data Studio hacks you want me to cover, shoot me an email or comment on this post. Cheers.